In the previous video, I demonstrated the scaling of application on Kubernetes, either using doing the manual scaling or using auto scaling feature. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate another feature where you can deploy your application, upgrade it from one version to another without causing the downtime. It's also called as zero downtime deployment. Let's have a look at it. List of deployed workloads that I have on my Kubernetes cluster. And I'm going to scale and deploy the front-end application using rolling updates or zero downtime deployment. In order to do that, first thing that I'm going to do is scale this application. Right now, there's only one instance running. There's no fun in deploying one instance in a rolling update at all. So I'm going to change that to 8 replicas. Those replicas actually get reduced to 5 later automatically, actually, that configuration. So when I start deploying, it would be 5 replicas that are my desired, that is my desired number of replicas. Let's assume it's 5. And I'm going to go ahead and create the rolling update configuration. This is where I define how to update. What is my batch size? How much time I want to wait between each of that batch? Let's say if I have a batch size of 2, 1 maximum surge and 1 unavailable. And I define 20 seconds as that minimum ready second. It would deploy with 2 in a batch of 2. So it will keep on repeating that process after every 20 seconds. So it would have a 20 seconds delay between the batches. So it is going to deploy in 4 batches here. I also need to choose the image that I need to deploy here. Now, after I made those changes, if I keep on refreshing, now the desired state has changed to 5. The image that I have for frontend has only one version. That's not very useful if I want to try out with different versions of the application. I'm going to give you another image which has been created with School of DevOps as an organization. So if you go to Docker Hub and School of DevOps /frontend, that image has so many versions, so many tags, and we're going to deploy version 3 and version 4 using rolling update configuration. Now, this is self-healed, so I don't have to worry about those errors, and ultimately I would have 5 instances of that front end running. Right now it's version 7.0.3, that's the default version that I have with my image. I'm going to also set up a refresh interval. So I have a plugin which keeps on automatically refreshing the browser page at a regular interval. I have defined the interval to be 4 seconds. You can also manually refresh it or install a Chrome plugin to do that. Now I have moved this to another window, and I'm going to define the rolling update configuration. This time actually I'm going to commit that configuration. Last time I was just showing it to you. I have changed the image to School of DevOps /frontend version 3.0, so V3.0, and it has started deploying the new version. Already, I see the next new version details here, and this is without downtime. So it is refreshing every 4 seconds. And as you see, the application does not go down. It is still available. Sometimes it shows version 3, that's a new version. Sometimes it shows the older version. That is expected because it is just doing a rolling update, and all of the available replicas of the pods would be added to the load balancer and would be live. That's the expected way for rolling updates. So you can have either the previous or the new version, but you won't have any downtime. Now, if you go back and keep on refreshing, you'll see that every 20 seconds a new update is rolled out. And some of these replicas are at version 2, some of those are at version 1. So I have a configuration where I want to have a surge of 1, so it has created 6 in total, 4 in the new version, 2 in the previous older version. That's what I see here. 4 updated, 6 in total, 2 are still being available. They're not available, they're being updated, and eventually all 5 would be in the desired state, and then the additional surged replica would be deleted eventually. That surge has been created just to support the deployment and have additional instances during that, and eventually you will see that it all of these instances would be running version 3. So now it is load balancing and I see only version 3 now. And if I refresh this as well, I would see the same. So front-end service, the service as well is pointing to all those replicas. 5 are running. One is an error because it is being deleted or removed, which is absolutely fine and expected. That's the first rollout with version 2. I'm going to deploy another version. So all I need to do here, so I see the 5 replicas. You see that 5 number? That's been reset to 5. I had started with 8 earlier, but it was reset to 5 later. To deploy the new version, all I need to do is go to the rolling update configuration, keep everything as same, and just update the version. This time I'm using version 4.0. So v4.0 is my tag. And again, it starts the rolling update, and I see the new version, that is revision number 3, and it is doing in batches of 2. So 2 containers are down, 2 are being updated, 1 has been created as a surge, so 6 in total, 2 are updated, and 4 are yet to be updated here. Again, this is refreshing, so I see version 4, and then I would eventually see version 3 as well. But again, as I mentioned, there is no downtime. This is without downtime, this is with zero downtime. This is also called as rolling update because it is rolling in batches, and our batch size is 2. So I'll have to refresh this manually in order to see this in action. So eventually it should move all the replicas to version 3. And when it does that, if I go back to the web page, I should see only version 4. And I should see the newer version that I have deployed, that is version 4 only. Again, some of these are being deleted, so that's why it's in error state, because eventually once the update is complete, the older replicas would be deleted. Now I see only version 4 here, and I'm going to stop that refresh, auto refresh, because the deployment has been complete and I have moved on to the newer version from the older version using rolling update. That is how rolling updates or zero downtime deployments work.